Hello.
Hi. I said hello.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. In correct English, it's I'm fine. Okay.
I'm fine. Yes, I'm fine.
Very well. Okay. First of all, tell us some headline of today. What's happening in the U.S.?
Let's see. First off, in Trump news, the Senate has set the impeachment date, the trial date in the Senate for February 8th.
You still want to do? Still want to do it?
Oh yeah, definitely. Justice needs to happen for inciting the riot and insurrection. So. It's not something little.
Come on, like he's an old man. He's playing his golf now. Why? Just let him off.
No. Then that will leave it open for someone else to do it.
Okay. What else?
Yeah, it doesn't seem a good example.
Okay.
Also, Biden signed more executive orders today.
Yes.
And those were mainly focused on COVID relief. He's kind of going really full on with the basically focusing on COVID. Okay. So that's where the main focus has been. And let's see. What else? Just more about vaccines and things like that and extra doses and Pfizer, all things surrounding that. More Senate confirmation hearings. Of defense secretary was confirmed today.
Okay,
so he'll be the new head honcho at the Pentagon.
Okay, talking about the virus, if we think that the virus can not be alive without the people, if they stay in your clothes, in your cell phone, in any other places, they can all live for certain hours, right? They can live for like 7 hours or 12 hours or 24 hours, then they die. Only if they get into human being, get your nose or ears or mouth, then you get affected. If that is the case, the quarantine should work. If we really don't touch each other for one day, for God's sake, everyone, same time, whole world. This day, I stay alone by myself. That could reduce a lot of numbers. Don't you think so?
It really could. Yes, I really do think so. And also, the numbers here have been going down. The infection cases, not the death rate yet, but the new infections have been going down.
Yeah.
But of course, there's fear because now the new type, the mutated type, is also here. So no one's being comfortable. No one's getting comfortable about the rate going down because this just you can't, not yet.
Because I also heard from this English. Prime Minister Johnson says this new type, the death rate is higher.
Yes. Well, they're trying not to panic people, and they're saying that it could be higher. It could be more infectious, actually. More infectious. More easily spread.
So more easily spread. So the more people get affected. Yeah, so the more people affected, then more people will die. This is Fauci says, yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So I really think so. If everyone control themselves, why don't the whole world leaders organize, say, have one day the whole world stop just for 24 hours? Even your husband and wife, if your husband and wife and the children or whoever, everyone stay 24 hours by yourself. So lots of virus will be killed just for one day.
Yeah. Do you think 24 hours is enough?
No. 24 hours at a time. Then a lot of effective virus will be gone. For example, if our kid come back from school, bring some virus to the store, to the kitchen, to all those places, if we no one touch them for 24 hours, this virus will die.
Yeah.
But within that 24 hours, if we touch, then we will get it.
Yeah.
You know, so by that, if you say, okay, 1 week, you know, about touch each other, it's not realistic. It's not realistic. And so we do 24 hours. We do it one day. And every week, we do one day. That will reduce. Yeah, I mean, we have to do together. The whole world have to do together. From this Big Bang clock. Okay. Which time?
Yeah.
And the whole world stop for 24 hours.
Mm.
No one should touch anyone. No human being should touch each other. And no war.
Yeah, just stop it all.
Yeah, stop everything. So I think, of course, this is very, you know, hypothetical.
Yeah, hypothetical.
Hypothetical.
A theory.
Yeah, it's a theory. Okay. Okay. Thank you. And we would like you every day. You are in America now, and you know everything is happening. So just check the headline. So what is the latest in USA? Just give us some hint. Then we will be very much appreciated. Yes.
I can give you a very big controversy, a very big criticism of Biden that came out today.
Yes.
He was wearing a Rolex watch at his inauguration.
Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah. Instead of like a Timex or something really cheap.
Yeah.
But the thing is, my father was in the Navy. He had a Rolex as well. It's stainless steel, not even gold or anything. And they're saying, oh, this isn't an every man type of watch. And that's all they can find. It's like Obama in his tan suit, how they made fun of him, or they criticized him.
That's terrible. I mean, Trump has a gold toilet.
Yeah.
I mean, this man should wear at least a gold watch, a gold Rolex.
Oh, and did I tell you what they found in the Oval Office?
Yes.
The button on the Resolute desk.
Yeah. You said it before. We say a Diet Coke.
But on a silver platter, the butler he would push the button, and the butler would have to come with a Diet Coke on a silver platter and serve it to him.
Mm.
So Biden had that removed.
Biden does not need a Diet Coke. So Biden can change it to ice cream button.
Yeah, but I think he saves ice cream for the weekends. So,
anyway, there's a controversy for Biden wear Rolex because Rolex is ordinary, it's not gold.
No, because it's not like a Timex, a really basic watch. Rolex, they're saying, is too good, which I don't understand. He's 78. He has earned the right to wear a nice watch. And it's not even gold, it's just stainless steel.
Why don't they... Why
it's
don't,
the same one my father had.
I know,
my
I know.
Was just
why don't they criticize Biden's hairstyle?
I don't know.
Why? Biden has white hair. Look, Trump has gold. Trump has gold hair.
So what should Biden do with his hair? What do you think?
We should criticize.
Make it blue or purple?
We should criticize
purple?
Biden together with his brother Bernie Sanders. they look awful. Look, Trump, how gorgeous he is. He has golden hair
and orange skin.
Except a couple of times it turned to be gray. Anyway,
okay.
Yeah.
Stress.
Okay, well, let's be serious. People would like to ask you, what do you think of the American immigration law for the new administration? They released the new law, immigration law, and give all these illegal immigrants their identity, I mean, their green card or citizenship. What do you think about that?
Well, actually, this has a long history of happening in the United States. So they've done this when we've had waves of immigrants in previous generations. They did this, I believe, with Italians, with the Germans, with the Irish. They did the same thing. So it's if you're in the country, they have a naturalization program. If you've been living here and paying taxes for, I believe, 7 years, even if you're undocumented, you're documented because you came here maybe on a student visa. So you got a Social Security number, you got a job, you pay taxes, and then your student visa just ran out, and you just kept living here. Well, instead of getting punished, they'll say, well, you've been paying your taxes, and you fit into society, you haven't been arrested, you haven't broken laws, you're a hard worker. Okay, citizenship, fill out the paperwork, and we'll just, we'll forgive that because you've been a good practicing citizen, so let's make it legal.
But now
they've done this in its previous years as well.
I know, but the history changed.
It's just that, well, the thing is, it's not new. It's just Trump went really okay. Honestly, what Trump did, and we're seeing what we now have to do is fix it. Okay, America has always been, it was founded on immigration. Okay. And then what happened was every new wave of immigrants that came, the ones that were here before, got upset over the new ones. And it didn't matter if they were English and then Germans came, they got mad at the Germans. If it was Germans and the Italians came, they got mad at the Italians. Then Irish came and the Italians had fights with the Irish. It's just always been that way. But then it smooths out and people say, oh, okay, well now we're all just like kind of people. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We're all just citizens after a certain amount of time. Mm-hmm. But what Trump really did was he played on the hate and the fights and the friction and the fear, basically, of people. So we don't need that. That doesn't make for a healthy society. We're a country of immigrants. And we, our tradition, and actually it has worked, is that we kind of like, it's been the best from other countries want to come here. I mean, we get the best computer engineers from, a lot of them come from India and Pakistan, and they came here for education, and then they ended up working on Microsoft products or Apple products, and that's how we just got like the brain drain from other countries, because in those countries they couldn't do it. They couldn't get a job. It wasn't even, didn't even exist then. So if we stopped immigration, you're going to stop all of that. You're going to stop getting the best and the brightest and getting this. You can't find in one geographical area or one race the best of everything. But if they're all coming here because they want to do something they can't do in their homeland, then you can get the best because you're getting them from all different cultures.
Okay, I have
it's
two.
Pretty cool concept.
I have 2 points. Okay, the first of all, I understood that what you said was that Biden wasn't doing anything new. He just bring the law back to normal. It was Trump.
He's just over.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, this is
he's
one point.
It.
Okay, second point is that you're talking about get all the smart guys. But the problem now is that people much from South America are all the working class. The most immigrants now.
That's what happened with the Italians as well as the Irish. They came here and they were seen as just, honestly, back then when they came, they were seen as the scum of the earth. Because they came with no education, no nothing. They were just laborers. So it was the same. But you know what? Those are the people who ended up building the roads and the railroads and the buildings, the skyscrapers.
So America needs all kinds of people, all kinds of people.
Yeah. Now, actually, one thing I really do like about Biden's plans are the upgrades to infrastructure that he has planned, because our infrastructure, our roads, railways, transportation has been just ignored for too many decades because it's old. We were one of the first countries to do a really comprehensive road system, and now the roads have been ignored for how many decades? And they need to be redone, and we need new high-speed trains from coast to coast in all the cities. And everybody wants that, especially if we want to have a cleaner environment.
Yeah, you want
this. We'll need people to build that, won't we?
You don't need people from South America to build your high-speed trains. You only need Chinese.
But Chinese come here. They don't want to do that. They want to buy houses and property. They don't build railroads anymore. That's when the Chinese came. They built the railroads to California.
Yeah.
Why would you say that wasn't a good thing? That was unbelievable.
Okay. Because it's Chinese people, you know, they forgot that they are immigrants themselves because they have the citizenship. Yeah. So scared that Seriously. The people from South America will come here to take their welfare away.
Now, every medium to large city in America has a Chinatown. Why do you think that is? Every single one.
Chinatown. Yeah.
Yeah. There's a Chinatown here in Las Vegas. In my hometown, Philadelphia, there's a big Chinatown.
Okay.
Everywhere.
Okay. Understand. Okay. Thanks very much for your... give us this, historical lesson. History lesson that we know that America is an immigrant country, and Biden isn't doing anything new. Okay, Biden is just do as America always do. It was only Trump was trying to change something, and Biden was only bring these things back. Okay, this is we got your point.
Trump was really playing on the group of his followers are primarily white, okay? And when they see other people coming, he was playing on this fear that I'm sorry, but a lot of white people have this fear that they're going to become irrelevant or something, even though they're the majority of the population. And I don't understand what that is, but I think it has to do with the fact, like, they were able to storm the Capitol and only one of them got killed because they have this thing that goes with them of white privilege, just being white. They don't even have to do anything special. Okay. They don't even have to have a special skill. The color of their skin gets them what they want.
Yeah, can I ask you a personal question? Okay, thanks. That's it. Okay.
I'm not free.
Okay.
Don't worry.
Good, good. And okay. Please keep us updated and look at the headline every day and give us what is the most important thing happening in America, because the Chinese media only pick up things they are interested, misleading, you know, people. So if you could tell us what is the most important thing that Americans look at every day, we would be very much appreciated. Very helpful. Thank you, lady.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will do.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
大家好，刚才跟本次老师就谈了几个问题啊，就是说从今以后呢，就是我希望本次老师每天能够看一看啊，这个美国的头条，就美国人最关心是什么问题。这样的话呢，就是说通过我的节目，我们可以找到最新的有关美国人最关心的事情。因为我发现这个中文的这些媒体啊，尤其是反共的这些媒体啊，都只是关心他们的那些事情。OK， 所以经常把我们这个中国人以为啊，他们谈的那些事情是最要紧的。那么你们看我的节目的话呢，你们就知道美国人最关心的在目前是什么啊。这个事情呢，就是说啊，希望大家那个对我们的节目会有所了解。我再说一遍啊，我们的节目受到这个我不能说是受到了压制啊，但是至少是受到了这个不被推荐 OK， 所以呢我们的这个观众越来越少啊。在这里呼吁大家，请大家把我们的频道介绍给你们的朋友，如果你觉得我们这个频道啊是有价值的话。那么今天讲了几个什么事情呢？第一个事情就是讲到这个 川普的问题啊，就说川普还是要弹劾他。我想这个川普已经都退下去了，对吧？现在打高尔夫了，不是就是放他一把算了吗？你何必那么痛打就落水狗呢，对吧？但是好像美国人也有这种痛打落水狗的精神啊。这个我是觉得不太公平啊，就是说你既然是搞民主嘛，你民主你这个川普另外一个机会嘛，如果说是全美国人民不认可他，你四年之后再选也选不上他嘛。如果四年之后全美国人民仍然认可他选他，那就是民主的力量嘛，你为什么不敢给他这个机会呢，对不对？所以这一点呢，我是觉得啊，这个民主党有点小气啊。当然不知道结果如何啊，最后这个弹劾能不能成功啊，如果弹劾能成功的话，那川普的政治生涯基本就是结束了啊。那么我们相信川普总统啊，就前总统，他会用同样的方法 fight。 OK， 这是一个事情。第二个事情呢，就是讲到这个疫苗的事情啊，就是这个英国的这个强生啊，首相说这个新的型的这个病毒啊，就杀伤力更强，包括这个死人率好像都更高。但是美国的佛奇说呢，虽然没有证明它的死亡率更高，但是它是另外一种方法说的，就是它更加容易传播。更加容易传播的结果就是更多人得病，更多人得病的结果就是更多人死啊，是一样的啊。那么现在就是美国在这个疫情、这个疫苗的分配各个方面啊，一直存在很多问题啊。当然说这个拜登呢，还在这个问题上还是用了很大的力量啊，在使劲非常大的力量啊。那么他同时讲到，就是说最近在美国啊，就是不是最近的，就是今天在美国讨论的一个话题。就是由于这个拜登啊戴了一个劳力士的手表啊，这个劳力士的手表我都不要戴了。我那个是年轻的时候，我原来是戴劳力士，后来戴了一个 Omega， 后来就觉得太重了，真的太重了。我现在有一块手表是这个真的是德国的手工的一个手表，做得非常非常漂亮。这手表都太重，我都不要戴。我现在是戴一块非常非常轻的，在日本这个普通的这个杂货店买的，大概就是$20。我一直这些年都在戴这样的表，为什么？非常轻，它不但轻，它还有日期，还有星期啊，而且这个日期是星期，既有英文的，还有日语的。我是因为看日语看惯了，我是把它调到日语的，所以我非常希望这个手表嘛，它就是一个方便嘛。好像就是说，你看看你拜登啊，你戴个劳力士啊，你太不拼命了嘛，对吧？你应该戴一个普通的什么个啊，几十美金的，这个事情也去说人家啊。你不想想，川普总统那个马桶都是金子做的，对不对啊？这川普总统是有一个按钮，在那办公桌一个按那个按钮啊，就人们就要。端一个用银子的杯子，端一个这个啊 Diet Coke 啊，就是减肥的可口可乐给他喝啊。我当时开了一个玩笑，我说拜登应该装一个按钮啊，一摁就有人给人送这个 ice cream 啊，送这个冰淇淋给他吃啊，这当时开玩笑。所以呢，我早就说过啊，你看川普总统是多么有故事啊，天天都有故事讲，到了拜登没故事讲了吧。没东西讲了，对不对？你在奥巴马的时代就讲奥巴马一个领带戴的怎么怎么样啊，这个西装穿的怎么样啊，就去拿这些说事儿。你现在拜登戴个手表个劳力士，哎呀，那你说他日本的不动产的劳力士是标配 ，OK， 日本的不动产的这些小的这些就是营业者，这个营业的就是跑生意的这些人，劳力士是标配。OK， 稍微上面一点点的当老板的都不戴劳力士，戴我这样的最便宜的，因为轻啊。所以这种东西说人家真的也是就说明拜登没故事讲啊。你像我昨天做了拜登这个视频就没人什么人看啊，就是看人家少，你讲川普哦你就多啊。那么今天呢，主要是跟奔驰老师讨论了一下这个一个移民问题啊，就是说这是一个观众的提问，就是你帮我问一问奔驰老师啊，他对这个拜登的移民政策怎么看啊？结果按照奔驰老师的解释呢，就并不是拜登有什么新的政策，而是拜登只是维持了历史以来的所有的美国的移民政策，他只是没有改变。仅仅是川普的时代他有所改变而已，至少他想改变。 是这个意思，就是说美国它一直就是一个移民国家啊，基本上奔驰老师就是个这个就是基本上奔驰老师就是解释了这美国历史啊，以前啊就是说英国人来了，这个德国人来了，这个意大利人来了，什么跟荷兰来了，瑞典人来了，然后慢慢就是墨西哥人也过来，就讲的这个故事啊，就是说美国是需要移民的啊，移民既有很聪明的啊，也有这个一般的劳动者，他们就是做苦工啊，包括中国人。他也提了个问题，他说你们中国人不都是移民吗？你们怎么忘记自己是移民了？现在就很怕别人来移民，对不对啊？关于这个事情呢，我是这么看这个问题啊。美国的移民问题，你要看站在什么样的角度讲。你是要看着你站在一个美国人的角度来看这个问题，还是站在一个移民的角度来看问题，这完全是不同的。我先从一个美国人的角度来讲一讲啊，如果说我是美国人啊，那么我是美国人，我把美国建设好了，我当然不希望别人跑到我家里来贪我的便宜，占我的好处啊，但是我欢迎别人到我家来帮我做苦工，对吧？因为我一个农场很大，对不对？你如果说是来帮人说我给你打工啊，那我很欢迎。但是你一跑过来说你要跟我抢老婆，你要跟我抢这个我的资源啊，你要跟我在我的餐桌上抢这个面包，那我当然就不同意了。所以这是一个原则问题，对吧？作为一个美国人，这个国家也是这么来的嘛，每个国家都是为了保护自己国家嘛，保护自己国家的人民，就是我们辛辛苦苦把这个国家干起来，我不希望别人来跟我抢我的资源，但是我希望别人到我这里来花钱。比如任何国家都是啊，中国人有钱了，你说这个什么希腊啊什么东西，欢迎你来，你来投资，你来花钱啊，希腊就是明显你来买了房子啊，你就可以拿到居住权，但是你不能工作啊，你只能消费，你可以到我这里来消费消费消费，但不是我不让你赚钱啊，等到几年之后你消费的差不多了，你才可以赚钱，它都是有一个这样的过程，这个全世界是一个样的啊。但是作为一个移民的角度来说，那就不同了，对不对？你看美国是什么国家啊？为什么那一天的20号的这个拜登的这个登基啊，那个仪式，我为什么没有看？我只看了一个人唱歌，我就说我不喜欢。其实我现在回忆起来，也许那个歌手真的唱得很好，也许是我不在那个心情上而已。你看他怎么唱的啊？这是我的土地，这是你的土地，从加利福尼亚到什么维吉尼亚还是什么啊？我说这个人要不要脸啊？这个美洲大地怎么变成了你的土地了？什么时候变成你的土地了？这个明明是人家印第安人的土地，美国原住民的土地，抢吗？强盗吗？对吧？美国当时是英国人呢，跑过来抢，把他们杀掉嘛，就这么来的嘛，抢过来的土地嘛。好，他们先抢了，然后就其他的欧洲的移民慢慢的过来啊。其实西班牙的人还在前面，历史我就不讲了，就是说欧洲的全欧洲的人都跑过来，都是旧的移民恨新的移民，打击新的移民，这个新的移民站住脚了，又开始恨新的移民，这就是整个美国历史，都是就是强吃弱的这样一个历史啊。那么就是说你移民过来以后，关键是你强不强，你要强你就站得住脚，你是弱你就站不住脚。所以现在全世界的移民，从道理上讲，你凭什么说这个美洲这块土地是你的，是你美国的，就是因为我有军队嘛，我有政府嘛，我可以把你关起来嘛，那就是强嘛。那么如果说是南美洲的人民啊，不是1000万，不是2000万，拿2-3个亿怎么办？两三个亿同时插进来，你拿激光枪扫吗？这就是强不强大的问题啊。你到了美国，你强不强悍？美国是一个要强悍才能站住脚的，不管你是怎么来的，真的，不管你是什么途径到了美国啊，你是学生身份也好，你是这个非法的偷渡的也好，什么也好，你只要是强者，你在美国就能站住脚，就能拿到身份，就能移民，就能是美国公民，否则的话你就是弱势，你就永远被踩在底下， 美国就是这么一个国家。所以说事实上啊，虽然这个人类社会已经发展到今天，但是它的最最基本的还是一个弱肉强食的这个丛林法则，这个仍然存在，对不对？我的一个朋友啊，是一个法国人，法国人当时我在这个2002年我在好莱坞啊，他就在好莱坞待了7年了。我说你怎么什么签证？他说我没有签证啊。但我没有签证，我说那你怎么可以待这么长？那我就不回去啊。美国是这样，你来了，我不回去，就没人能够赶你的，不能赶你回去的。那怎么办？我说那你以后要回去怎么办？那等到我要回去再说嘛。到后来我就知道，这个朋友待了那个7、8年以后想回去了，后来他回法国去了。回去以后怎么办？他把护照换掉，换一个护照，他又来了。因为可能现在也不行了，在那个时候的话，他可能还没有这个。没这么健全，他登记的是这一本护照。这个我也意识到了，就是每次我到美国去的时候，比如说我换了新护照，他就问我你来不来过美国。我说嘿，美国我来那么多次，我在美国读了3次书，他们都不知道吗？他说他们只记录这一本护照里面的信息。我不知道现在是不是改正了啊？就是说我觉得你这样是个强者啊，你就不会担心有新移民来。当心新移民来的这个人的本身可能是一个弱者，就是我有我的东西了，我爸看不住，我怕别人抢我的。这个男人也是一样的吧，你老婆太漂亮太年轻了，是不是？你就担心了，担心你就不自信嘛，生怕别人把你抢走嘛，对吧？最好别人不要到我家里来。如果你是一个很自信的，你是一个很强壮的男人的话，你心里有数啊，你知道我这个老婆别人抢不走啊，对吧？我不但是自己老婆抢不走，别人的带老婆来，对不起，还说不定变成我小老婆了，对不对？这就是一个人的自信。所以说我觉得这是社会的一个这样。所以说我觉得任何一个国家没有理由去，你可以设很多很多的这个线去挡住那些你不需要的人啊。比如说美国你要考虑啊，我只需要两种人，一种是真正的 high tech， 真正是 high tech 就是科技人员啊，他们不会在政治上捣我的乱，对吧？不会出现一个什么呢？会影响到我的这个总统办公室去告诉总统办公室出馊主意，这个输得一塌糊涂。不会是这些人，而是真正是搞科技的这些人。我需要这样的人。另一方面，我就需要一些头脑简单、四肢发达的、专门的跟我干苦力的这些人啊。那么你就想，太聪明的我就不要，对吧？你经过检查，太聪明的、英语讲得再好的我就不要你。我只要这个四肢发达、身体健康的劳动力。这是对一个这个国家，这个每个国家政策嘛，对不对？其实这个人的这个基因啊是非常非常非常重要，真的。你想要一个这个本来就是说大脑粗啊，这个头脑简单，这个四肢发达这样的人，跑到美国就突然学了民主啊、自由啊，我就变得非常的 smart， 就变成了一个知识分子啊，不可能的啊。我就讲这个。一个女人养鸡啊，就是在这个达拉斯的一个叫妈妈什么农场的一个妈妈，她养鸡，她就养了这个养了很多蛋鸡啊，什么就各种各样的鸡都养了，她也养了这个120只这个肉鸡啊。她一看这个肉鸡啊，那个小时候的样子就不一样，但是她想呢这个实行这个鸡道主义嘛啊，这个鸡道主义就是给所有的鸡充分的自由，以充分的尊重啊，充分的鸡格。不是人格，鸡格。所以这些肉鸡是跟这些鸡是一起养的，都是放养啊，让他们出来玩呢、啊，一样的养。但是这些肉鸡它就不跟人亲，它就是吃了睡睡了吃，它就不跟这些鸡玩，而且呢也不交朋友，也不合群，而且到了4个星期就长得像大鸡一样。他就想，哎呦，那我还是多让他们多活一活嘛，就养6个星期、8个星期。得心脏病，一个个的死掉了，这就是基因。这个鸡就是人类研究出来的，专门给人吃肉的鸡，它就是这么长的。你要想改变它，把它用这个普遍的啊，这个鸡道主义，实行这个妈妈面前鸡平等的这样的搞法的话，其实就不行。为什么？它的基因就决定了。所以这个就是说，你美国也好，哪个国家好，你在移民政策的时候，你要看我要用什么样的人，你找一帮。又不能够科技做贡献，又不能够生产做贡献，还专门跟你在政治上捣乱的这样的人，你说就是一帮垃圾，有什么用，对不对？所以这个对国这个社会就有害 啊，所以你只要尽你有用的人就可以。这是对于这个统治者来说啊，对于劳动人民来说，我觉得你那些这个有头脑的人啊，有志向的人啊，你把自己国家搞搞好就行了吗？你到自己国家闹革命嘛，把自己国家那个皇帝推翻，你建立自己的国家不好吗？你要跑到别的国家干嘛呢？ OK， 这个啰里嗦嗦讲多了啊。好，今天的视频呢就讲到这里。再说一遍啊，每天我们都讲这个美国啊头条 ，OK， 最最美国人最最关心的问题，我们请奔驰老师跟大家讲一讲啊，我跟大家翻译一下，加一点我自己的解说。最后再讲一下啊，我们这个频道啊，受到某种理由啊，就是说越来越少了啊，所以呢，希望大家能够宣传我们的频道，能够把我们的频道介绍给你们的朋友啊，让我们这个频道能够存活下去。谢谢大家，再见，拜拜。